Hey, I'm Jordan North. You know what time of year it is? Well, was. Because it's no longer the season to be jolly, because I messed up so bad. And now you got to start rationing your food because you spent too much money on that Action Man figure for Christmas.
I'll give you realistic hair and gripping hands. There you go. Killed in Action Man.
And I procrastinated way too long to get this video finished in time for Christmas again. Travel back in time with me, won't you, to February 2021 to look at this Zenit 12 XP that is in that cabinet right there. Ooh. So after loading a cheeky cheat roll of Kodak's Ultramax 400, I said goodbye to my wrong dog, cleaned off my car, got my wife from work,
hello,
and headed out to the Ashdown Forest. So we decided to go to friend's clump to shoot. And yeah, I do mean Xi Jinping's fever dream of the 100 acre woods. So once we arrived at our beautiful windswept location, I took the best photo I've ever taken of a puddle. Doesn't it make you just want to jump in and have a swim?
Oh my God. No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
Honestly, I don't know what I was thinking with these first couple shots. And once I actually got over sadistically wasting film, we headed into the woods to start taking some good shots. To be honest, I'm actually quite happy with these. And they definitely give off a very dystopian sort of nuclear winter, post-Chernobyl, Fallout 4 kind of aesthetic, which obviously I love. So then we smartly decided to head out of the nice protected woodlands just to go into the coldest place in the entire area. And obviously I had to ask my wife to take her nice warm hood off just so I could take some pretty photos of her in the tundra level winds. And then my roll ran out as I was just getting into taking those photos. So to avoid getting murdered by her, we headed into a little makeshift tent we found just because it was a bit warmer than the outside. And I changed to a roll of HB5. And because I apparently love pushing my luck so much, I asked her to go back out and I took a couple more shots on this roll of film as well. But to be honest, it was definitely worth the risk, as it's quite nice to compare the black and white shots to the colour film in sort of the same setting and style of portraits. I also really love these shots, but I'm really torn because I love how the HP5 brings out like the crisp, nice, crunchy texture of the snow and just how like bleak it feels. But at the same time, the colour film has such a nice pop to it because just her bright red coat against the background of the like white tundra. Anyway, by that point the frostbite started to kick in, so we decided to just go back to the car, head home, and got one more shot on the way back. When we got back, I decided to use up the rest of the roll of HP5 on my broken pupper. And then a bit more of Ultramax, just because I love taking photos of that cat. In terms of photos, that's kind of it, because we're only granted 3 non-rainy days in the UK, and the snow just sort of disappeared by the morning. So the camera itself, you might be asking why I shot on this camera and not something else. It performs okay, and it is definitely just a beginner level camera. In fairness, it's more because it holds sentimental value than anything else, but I would have still chosen it over something like the Canon AE-1 anyway, because for snow at least, it kind of suits it, as it's quite a gritty, it's not perfect is what I'm trying to say. And that kind of works with it, because obviously nature isn't perfect anyway, and it kind of just, it helps make it the image feel a bit more organic, which is why I like 35mm film anyway, and all film. But 35mm specifically, because of how gritty and grainy it is, it kind of works nicely with that. But it is helped a lot by the Helios 58mm lens, which comes with it. Would I suggest buying this camera? Maybe. I mean, it depends if you've got a film camera and you're happy with that or not, because it's a really good starter because of how cheap it is and how affordable it is. But it does come with some caveats. One, the prisms can be really dodgy. So look it up when you look it up on eBay, because yes, they are cheap, but if you can't use the camera, there's no point in buying it. So if it has a bit of rot, what I call rot in the prism, where it has like a line down it, probably okay. But if it's completely gone, just don't bother, because there's no point fixing it if you could just buy a different camera for slightly more expensive. The lenses that come with it are really nice because it's the Helios 58, as I say. So if you just want that lens, maybe just buy that camera instead of buying the lens separately, as the lens separately is normally more expensive for some reason. So yeah, if you want that lens anyway, buy it and then you can try the camera out. It's quite a nice camera. It's very unique, not in the way it works, but just sort of in the feel of when you're using it. And definitely do not trust the light meters on it anyway. Just buy a separate cheap light meter, even if you're shooting on another camera, I suggest getting a light meter. And a spot meter would be even better than that, but again, they're more expensive anyway, and the older they are, the dodgier they are, so just get a cheap light meter to start out with. And of course, the only reason you should ever buy a camera, and you have to buy this camera, is because of where it's from.